For this privilege that you are giving unto us, O Lord, to be in your presence today.
Amen.
Father, Lord, King of glory, we appreciate, O Lord, for giving us the opportunity to see another good day, a day that is being blessed by you. Father, we just want to say thank you. Father, we sleep and we wake up, O Lord, O God. Father, we say thank you. Father, we are healthful, Lord. Father, we say thank you. All our body are complete. Father, we say thank you. You didn't allow our hearts to fail us, O Lord. Father, we say thank you. Thank you for the children that you are giving unto us that is not causing us sorrow, so Lord, O God. Father, Lord, may your blessing rest upon them. Mama, may they not cause us tears, O Lord, O God. Father, may we not weep over them, O Lord. But every sickness or disease, O Lord, O God, that any baby or any children here are born with, O Lord. Baba, with you, O Lord, O God, that sickness is over.
Amen.
That disease is terminated.
Amen.
In the authority name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because our womb is a blessed womb, O Lord. It's not a womb that has been cursed, O Lord. But whatever that comes out from our womb is blessed. But they are unstoppable. Father, we say thank you. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' marvelous name, I pray.
Amen.
Let's jam our hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah. We can sing Dan and Queen and King in the house. Amen. I titled my message today, What Tree Are You? Amen. My message of today, What Tree Are You? Amen. We have many words, many trees. There are some for healing. There are also some trees you cannot go near them. There are also some trees that bear fruits well we eat today. Amen. What tree are you? Hallelujah, somebody. Amen. And the Lord God Almighty says, above all that we are tree, is the greater trees where we start from. He says, anyone being abide in him will never be cut off. And God Almighty himself is the largest tree that we come from. We become what? A branch. But anyone who abide in this tree, which is Jesus, you can never be aborted. I want to tell you today that when you believe, and it will work for you. That when you believe, your stronghold is over. When you believe. And when we also abide in God. Today we are talking, oh, what tree are you? What fruit are you bearing? Oh, we are the sons of Abraham. We are the daughters of Abraham. And I want to tell you, we have lifted our hands up and says, Lord, bring our enemies down. Father, do this and do that for us. That our struggle, our problem is over. It's only when we abide in Christ. Amen. It's only when we do what? When we abide in Christ. When we are out of Christ, your struggle, I believe you, it will never be ended. Amen. It's only when we abide in Christ, our struggle is ended. It's only when we abide in Christ, we can boast of tomorrow. It's only when we are in what? In Christ. Let's check our hearts and look at ourselves. In everything that I am doing, am I seeing in Christ? Am I seeing abiding in God's word? In this, my character? In my way of doing? In my way of coming to church? In my way of serving God? Am I seeing in Christ? Amen. That is what the question we need to ask ourselves. The way that I am serving God, is it this way God wants it to be? In my way of talking, am I seen in Christ? Am I talking like somebody that is in Christ? When some of us speak, he said, by their fruits we shall know them. When they speak, he will know who is in them. Hallelujah, somebody. Don't allow proud overtake you. Drop proudness. Hallelujah, somebody. Drop seniority. We are in Europe. They cannot add anything to your hours, neither your what, your happiness. What you need to do, humble yourselves so that those who look at you will know that truly who tree you are. Whether you are the tree that people will come to and they will be blessed. There are some trees when sun is too much, you hide under them just to refresh yourselves. There are some trees when sun is too much, you cannot hide under them. The sun will also do what? Beat you. There are some trees, even when rain is falling, you go under them, the rain will not touch you. What tree are you? And what fruit are you bearing? In yet today in Christianity, we have seen that proud have overtaken many hearts. Proud. I did not blame many because they had not count the money that they are counting here in Nigeria. I believe that one made them to go crazy, some of them. Amen. Then let me tell you that those things that you think and you put your trust, when you now see somebody, you look at that person as nothing. It is God that makes those things to come some to you. Without God, you cannot have those things. And God knows the purpose why he blesses you. God did not just bless you for blessing's sake. It's for a purpose. And you ever sit down and begin to think, why did God bless me? Why did God make me not to die in the Red Sea? I am here in Europe. Why? Are you ever sitting down and think about it? Did you think that it's only you they know? Because of you they know God make you not to die in the Red Sea and overcome that Red Sea and come to this land of Italy or wherever that you are. God is waiting for you to raise somebody up. God is waiting. If your Europe in Europe does not give anyone joy back home in Nigeria, you are in Europe for nothing. If you are not giving what? Anybody's joy. God bringing you here is for somebody over there to be boasting of you. Can your parents boast of you? Can your brothers and sisters boast of you? Some people will say, I will not call them my dear. I have sent them money. They are eating all the money. You don't have money, my dear. If you have money, you will not be crumbled of 200 or 300,000 that they have eaten.
Because you don't have the money. When you have the money, those things are what? Those things that they have eaten is what? It's just because God wants them to do what? To eat it. That makes it to do what? To cause it to your hand. Don't knock. Only bag of rice. Told them to buy bag of rice. They go and buy half bag of rice. They are eating my money. And you begin to say, because of that, you will not call them again. If pregnant, you are proud. Stop it. I love this music very well. Some people will say, mama, na worldly music. Now you know. But the word that is inside me, I like it very well. He said, make the woman say, chop my money. He said, I don't care. Because he know that there is bunch in what? In account. That the more you eat, the more God blesses me. Please and please, let those in Nigeria feel happy because you are in Europe. Don't let her hear your call and say, tell that sister that not there around. Tell that brother that I'm not there around. If you call and so, so shout, shouting in one shout. Please stop it. Behave as one, as mature, because you are mature. By you traveling from Nigeria to Europe, you are matured. May the Lord help us. What tree are you? Can your brother not hide under you and begin to boast of you? Can your sister not hide under you and begin to boast of you? Even in our Christianity, you say you are a Christian. Can somebody in Nigeria not say, oh, I have a sister, I have a brother that is a Christian. I know that he can stand for me and intercede. Can they boast of you? Or you are still the one, still carrying for disturbing them. Is that Babala one is still around? Is that woman that used to do something, he don't die, I be never die? Please stop it. God is looking unto you. Bear a good fruit for God. Let's open our Bible to the book of Proverbs 11. Let's see what the Bible wants to tell us there. The book of Proverbs. Proverbs 11. We are taking it from verse 16 of it. Hallelujah.
Proverbs 11 from verse 16. A gracious woman retaineth honor, and strong men retain riches. The merciful man doeth good to his own soul.
Amen. Did you hear? He said, a gracious woman with honor for her husband. Amen. Many women today, they use their mouth to tear their husband down. Many, they thought maybe they are reigning, they are in Europe. They can speak anyhow because of the coins they have in their pocket. Their husband has become slave in their hands. And which is not supposed to be. The Lord is saying here, a good woman with honor for her husband. Are you winning honor for your husband? Or you are the one that will bring your husband out and begin to tear him down? Please, if you are doing it, repent. He said, righteous is true of dishonor for him. Please and please, let us be what? Righteous. Do things that you know that is good, not of evil. For that, the Lord God Almighty, he will bless us. Let's go further.
Verse 17b. But he that is skilled troubleth his own flesh. To him that soweth righteousness shall be sure reward. As righteousness tendeth to life, so he that pursueth evil pursueth it to his own death. They that are of forward heart are abomination to the Lord. But such as are upright in their way are his delight. Though hand joined in hand, the wicked shall not go unpunished.
Amen. You hear what he says? Whether you like it or not, any evil that you are doing, you are not going to be free in the hands of God. It is for that for us to do what? To repent and begin to do what? To do good. So that we can be free from the wrath of God. People will say, ah, I have been doing it, nothing happened to me. Continue, clap for yourself and continue. Every day for the owner, one day for the what? For the thief. Just begin to do whatever that you are doing. But God is watching every one of us in anything that we are doing. Don't think that you can handle it what? Alone. Leave it for God to do. Don't say somebody has hurt me. It is my time now to do what? To revenge. Don't revenge for yourself. Leave it for whom? For God. Amen. And God Almighty, He will do the revenge for you.
But the seed of righteous shall be delivered. As a jewel of gold in the swine is not, so is a fair woman which is without discretion. The desire of the righteous is only good, but the expectation of the wicked is wrath.
Amen. He said the desire of what? Of the good person, the righteous person, those who are born of spirit, their thoughts towards the things of God, towards one another, they only thought of good for one another. They have never won the sitting down, be thinking of evil to one another. They only think of good. Whether the person is small or big, the thoughts that they have is for everything to be well with us. It's for that brother to grow up. It's only that word is manifesting here in Italy. If any Italian man sees that somebody, whether it's for their family or not, that person is raising up, he will see everybody gathering up and do what? And lift tell that person up. It's only my country, permit me to say, some people, when they go home, they want to establish something. You will hear a week the person sleep no way or not, so he had failure. Amen. He died. People are even afraid to go and do what? Establish in their country. Me and you can make a what? A difference. We can make a difference. And some people will say, oh mama, don't you talk about Nigeria. Nigeria is what? It's finished. Nigeria is that. Nigeria is that. It's when God have not stepped into the case of Nigeria. That makes you to look Nigeria at that way. But by the time God stepped into the case of Nigeria, everything will turn around. It will turn around. I believe that God can never abandon that country for the enemy to be what? To be molesting. Never. When God arise, all the enemy that making Nigeria not to be settled, they will be brought down. Amen. They will be brought down. Amen. I believe strongly that God is never hard for God to do. When he seals a thing, he comes to do what? To pass. What tree are you? Are you the one still calling there in Nigeria? Insulting your parents? Insulting your brothers and sisters? Please stop it. Repent from it. A day we call you, we also have your children. Whatever you do to your parents, your children will do it unto you. Amen. Somebody be saying, oh, the pastor catch my mother, wish I will not call that my mother again, I will not call that your my father again. I said, that your pastor is the greatest wish in your life. Amen. Amen. I said, somebody who has carried you for 9 months, when you mess up, he cleans you. Now that you are big, and they are telling you that he's the one wishing you, I said, you are the one wishing yourself. I said, if it is me, your parents are the wrong from you. Amen. Please and please stop it. And move on. Call them, love them. So that when you have your children tomorrow, and then we also love you. The Bible says anyone that respects us is parents, your day will be long. Your day will be long. Respect your parents, those the parents in our life. Cherish them so that your days will be long. If you are the one causing them before, go and beg and tell them that you are sorry. You don't know what we are doing. So that your days will be long. The righteous people win souls to the kingdom of God. Those who are born of spirit, they win souls to the kingdom of God. But the foolish one uses their tongues to do what? To drive them away. What seed are you? What fruit are you? Many who are doing these secrets, you thought that pastor is not here. Nobody in the church seeing you. When you are in the midst of them, you tear the church of Satan. You say, who is that pastor? I am just going there for going's sake. But God Almighty is looking at you. As you are saying it, people know the kind of fruits that you bear. He knows that you are not in Christ, you are out of Christ. Because if you are in of Christ, you cannot stand up and do what? And insult anyone that preach the word of God unto you. You cannot use your tongues to tell the church where you come to pray, where you lift your hands up and say, Father, do it. Where you call and you hold like a foe and you begin to sell your testimony. You are like a dog. A dog vomited, they go back to their vomit. Repent. If you are doing it, repent. Repent. People hide in the corner, calling people, telling them, oh, you didn't come to church today. It is better for you. But God Almighty is watching you. On the day that God will open your book of Chronicles, and you will see, and many of us are complaining. We are full of complainers. Check yourself, my dear, because you are out of Christ. No one saved God and bites his hands. No one saved God and remarried the same. God can never use you and empty you. He can never. When you put your trust in him, he make it possibility to be possible. When they were showing out to me, I don't know whether it's true or not true, they bring it out in them. In their Facebook, an old woman giving birth. Amen. An old woman giving what? Giving birth. I believe that old woman, he menstruation don't take away end. Amen. To me and you, it's an what? It's an impossible. To God Almighty, there is nothing that is not what? Impossible for him to do. That is the reason I don't join them to sing that song, that what God cannot do does not exist. Who taught you? Amen. Who taught you? I don't join them to sing that song. I don't limit my God. Even things that does not exist, to God he exists. To me and you does not exist. To God there is nothing that does not what? Exist. We have saw it in the Bible. Where a man stood up and said, I know that this thing cannot be what exists. I will not see an animal half of man, half of animal. And God make it to what? To exist for him to see. To you, it does not exist. To him, there is nothing that does not exist. Amen. Everybody will now pick and begin to say it. Is it your word? May that person know at that very moment that he was moved of what God did for him or her, and he sang that song. It doesn't mean that you too will also do what? Being the same class. Amen. Hallelujah, somebody. Come a song for them. For them, what they can let me exist. And you are far from God. You are far from God. You are just saying, you are not saying it just to do what? To cover up. Everybody knows who you are. It's only you are pretending and doing what? Deceiving yourself. By your way of doing, by your speaking, we know the fruits that you bear. Whether you are the one that bears the fruits of what? Of peace or not. There are some fruits, when you eat it, you will die. There are fruits, you will eat it, fruits are you? What fruit are you? Are you still the one pretending following a friend on his back? You are destroying that friend. Repent. Repent. Be wise. Don't allow your words of arrogance to put people away in the house of God. Don't allow your dirty character to put people away in the house of God. Don't do. Don't do. There are some people who are tired. They have backslides, but they are still committed to church. They are looking for one person to offend them, to step on their toe, so that they can say, because of you, that is the reason why I left the church. Don't fall on their word, on their charm. Amen. Don't do. God know that. God knows them that they are about to do what? To give up. Don't allow them to say, you are the one. Because when Jesus Christ comes into this world, he knows that he will go unto the cross and die for all. He said, but woe unto that man that betrayed the Son of a man. You know, everything has been what? Arranged before. But Judas Iscariot went to go and do what? And fall into the trap. Amen. Because it was not only him was the 12 disciples. There were many. But the Lord says, I know that I will go to the cross. But woe unto that man that betrayed the Son of Man. God knows that brother, that sister, how weak is about to leave. But may you not go and use your character to do what and not to push him or her away. So that he will not sense it because of you. That God knows every heart of all men. God knows them and is watching. Are you still in the Christ? Let's see the book of John. John 15:1. Check yourself whether you are still in the Christ. In what you are doing. He will tell you whether you are seeing what in Christ or not. John 15 from verse 1.
I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he takes away. And every branch in me that beareth fruit, he purges it, that it may bring forth more fruit.
Amen. Is anyone that abide in Christ, when he said he projects it, and God keep you what? Alive. Because you are a soul winner. Because he knows that you are good. He said, but those who use it, their tongues to tear the house of God down. He said, the time will come, the Lord will end that person. May that one not be our portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
He said, abide. He said, I am telling you the truth. Abide in Christ. Abide in him. People will say, oh mama, and we are enjoying. Your enjoyment does not mean that you will be out of Christ. Amen. You can enjoy yourself, you are seeing what? In the Christ. It's only when the enjoyment of some of us, after we are taking much alcohol, and we are no longer in ourselves again, and the spirit of alcohol is not controlling you, you begin to insult your pastor, insult your church. Amen. Because you are what? You are empty. People have enjoy yourself and go home and sleep, and do not curse God. Amen. By the time you use your mouth to tell your church outside and saying that man is not good, that woman is not good, the way this one behaved, this way this one not behaved, because you are no longer yourself again. Because there is another spirit that is working in you. And when you now come to normal, when they ask you, and when they are praying here, anyone that is using their mouth to tear this ministry, to talk about the ministry, Holy Ghost fire, and you are joining on calling Holy Ghost fire. Amen. Repent. There are certain things, the Bible says, there are certain things you think Think it, don't say it. So that nobody will hold you and say, it is your word. It is your word. Don't say it. The moment you say it, they will know where the word comes from. They will know this one is your own word. It's your word. Abide what? In Christ. Amen. Abiding in Christ does not mean that you will not enjoy. Enjoy your word, your life. Enjoy. If you don't enjoy here in Europe, where do you want to enjoy? Amen. Amen. Where did you want to enjoy? Enjoy what? Yourself. Don't use hungry except you want to demand greedy like me. Don't use hungry to do what? To beat your stomach or refill your stomach. Amen. Except when you are praying, when you are fasting, or when you want to do diet. If not, what stops you not to enjoy? Hallelujah. Amen. Sickness will not stop you not to enjoy. Utterly death will not stop you not to enjoy.
Amen.
In the authority name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's go on.
Verse 3. Now, here I claim through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branches cannot bear fruit on itself, except abide in the vine, no more can you, except ye abide in me. Verse 5. I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit.
Amen. That is where I says we should seal before. Are you abiding in Christ? He said, those that abide in him, and he will also do what? Abide in us. When you go down, he said, anything that we ask, it will be given unto us. If only when we abide in Christ. If you are praying for something, that something I want, or check yourself and say, Father, where? I am not abiding in you. Is it in my tithes? Because he's the one that gives you what? Job. Some of us will say, it is my strength. If you see the work when I am walking, if you see the capon when he dead here, continue to mock your word yourself. The problem is always around you. Anytime you are always complaining and struggling, in that area you are out of Christ. Can you not lift your hands up? You that are eating God's money. And say, Father, cause your rain of blessing to rain upon me. We say, shut up, drop that your hand. Because you want to come and rape where you have not walked, where you are also. He said, I have given you good health. I have given you job. I demand of one tenth of it. If anytime the pastor preach about it, you say, change that topic. It's for your own good, not for me. I am not the one complaining, but you are the one complaining. Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
If you want to be what? To be blessed. Don't rob God. So that God will not open a door for the enemy to rob you also. Don't rob God. Our God is a merciful God. He's a merciful God. Sometimes things that many of us do, I will just look at them and say, our God is a merciful God. Please and please, abide in Christ. Abide in him. I love that verse 4 so much. He said, abide in me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine. No more can ye except ye abide in me. I am the vine. Yes, I am the branch. He is that abide in me and I in him. The same bring forth much fruit. For without me, ye can do nothing. Meaning without God, we cannot wake up this morning. Without God, that document cannot come our hand. Without God, that job cannot come our hands. Without God, this all whatever that we acquire today, it will not come unto him. Unto us, without what? Without him. Know it. Abide in this God so that he will do greater things for us. Those who are wise, they fear God. It's only the foolish people does not fear God. That we say God understand. Amen. That is their language. Amen. They say, Mama, don't worry, God will understand. I will just look at them, God will understand. Even your children, when you tell your children that you have no money, they cannot understand. You are saying, God will understand. Continue. Clap for yourself and continue to speak that wrong English that God will understand. Instead of you to say, Father, have mercy on me. And give me the grace to change, to abide in you. And let your fear come unto my life. That is the song that's supposed to sing. Not God, we understand. I prayed for somebody. Ultimate death is not your portion at all. It's not your portion. God Almighty knows what he's doing. And the verse. Cease of it. He said, if a man abide not in him, he is cast forth as a branch, and he is withered. And a man gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. Amen.
Amen.
When you thought that all that you have is for you alone, a time will come. I wonder sometimes people begin to worry, oh, this woman was a rich man before. Now, they say, Italian people, they will say, bancarrota. I say, why your bank will not rot up before? Why your account will not empty before? Why your account will not show rot up before? Because all those money that you have, you thought that it's for you alone. And God are bringing something to do more, to make that money to be more, to be nothing. And they begin to cry. You see many now, and when they don't fall, for Nigeria now, no where to run to. Here now, when they fall, when their back and rotor, for them to cover up, they will go and join this thing that you people are looking. Grande Patello, you see them, just to bring themselves out again. Because they have to what? Many they have fall. For that shame not to come. What have you done with all those money that God has ushered into your hands? Many is ashamed. Even many takes their lives. But we in Africa, we are born as a poor person. But God is raising us up as a rich man. That is the reason when we have fall or not fall, we look at it as if that we are still rich. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Nothing shaking, so those things does not shake us. That is what I used to tell my husband. I say, it is you people that is panicking. Oh, money is going down in the bank, you are panicking. For us, we are born with empty. Our mother did not keep money for us. Our father did not keep money for us. When we see one another is in our account, we say we are the top. Amen.
Amen.
Nothing shakes us. When the one another goes down, we know that tomorrow, two naira will come in again. I said, that is the reason. You can never see any African man who say, because I don't have money, he will go and kill himself. I said, that one, it does not exist. I said, for you people, it's very many. I said, because your mother and your father have been doing it for you, and when you now go, because you are what? You are lazy like our youth. Our government calls our youth lazy youth. Amen. Truly, many of our youth, we are what? We are lazy. Truly, you can see Chinese, you will see store here, they will open store here, they are doing what? Tailor, you open them, you see them, that one naira, that two naira that you give them, your cloth, sew it for me, iron it for me, hem it for me, they are collecting one euro, by the time month end, you will see what they will give. Our youth, if you call them, even to be dropped, some of them don't know how to do it. Even to stand, to sing, some of them don't know how to do it. Even to put pots on fire and pour rice, Some of them don't know how to do it. All that you want fastly. You want to wake up in the morning and begin to see yourself riding Ferrari. It cannot happen. Anyone that is running that race, meaning he's digging the early grave, that is the reason the youth are dying anyhow in Nigeria. And people say, oh, mama, they got crazy. I say, why would they not got crazy? Because you didn't enter primary one, you want to do university in exam. It can never be possible for you to pass it. It can never. Somebody that are up to 50 years, what is acquired? You 20 years want to compel yourself with sin. You will fail. Please and please. Abide in Christ. All that we are searching for, all are in the hands of God. They are not in the hands of man. He said at the appropriate time, he will come. There are things God delay not to come into your hand now. Just because when he comes down, your early grave is so closed. Because of that, he wants to spare your life. He don't want those things to come earlier. So that you will be alive. He hindered Moses for good 3 months. He hindered Jesus. If Jesus comes out at that very moment, maybe Aaron could have succeeded. But God knows the reason why he told it for the enemies to pass. You don't know the reason that car and whatever that you are pursuing, the reason God don't want you to have it at this your age. You don't know. You don't know. But God Almighty, he will help us. Amen. Let's stand on our feet. Let's stand on our feet. Check yourself. Look into your heart. Am I safe in the Christ? Am I abiding in the Christ? Or I am out of Christ in one way and the other? Is it for your tithes that you are out of Christ? Ask God for mercy and repent from it. Is it your coming to the house of God that you are not coming well? Anytime they call you, or if they call you before you come, ask God. I say, Father, where am I out of you? Because your word says, if we abide in you, you will abide in us. That whatever that we ask, you will give it unto us. Check yourself where you are out. Where you are not abiding in the Lord. Lift up your hand and say, Father, give me the grace to abide in you. Give me the grace. Let your grace be sufficient for me to abide in you. Let your grace be sufficient for me. Everyone that are not here today, that are weak, Father, we pray for them. Give them the grace to abide in you, Lord, so that you will abide in them, O Lord, according to your word. So that whatever that we ask you, Lord, you will do it for us. Father, Lord, so that in times of trouble, you will deliver us. Father, help us. In Jesus' name we pray. Going to pray this prayer. Just listen and we read it, then you will turn it into prayer. May the word of God abide in me, in Jesus' name. Pray that the word of God will abide in you. May the word of God abide in you, and nothing will bring you down. No noise of men and women will be able to shake you in the house of God when the word of God abides in you. The devil will not come and molest you with his trickies. So that whatever that we ask God, he will give unto us. In Jesus' name. Prayer is still going on. May the word of God made manifest in my life. Pray that the word of God will be made manifest in your life. Father, let your word may manifest in our lives. Let your word may manifest in this ministry. Let your word may manifest. Because the Bible says the thoughts that you had for us is not of evil, it's of good. Let your word may manifest. In Jesus' name we pray. We are still going to pray. He said, may the physical power comes upon me to obey God's command. Pray that the physical power will come upon you to obey the command of God. Not the command of man, but the command of God. It matters in your lives. Father Lord, give us the physical power to obey, O Lord of God, your command. Give us the physical power. He said, before Sarah can bear Isaac, he said, the physical power to carry that pregnant comes upon her. If not, she will not be able to receive that baby in her womb. Or say that physical power comes upon you. I pray for somebody today. I pray for those that are watching me from afar. I pray for those that is under my voice today. You will receive that physical power for that blessing to come into your head. For that blessing to make manifest in your life. In the authority name of Jesus. Those that are searching for documents. The physical power will come upon you.
Amen.
For you to receive that your document.
Amen.
Those that are looking for a job. Amen. The physical power, it will come upon you. Amen. So that you can receive that job.
Amen.
In the authority name of Jesus.
Amen.
We are going to pray lastly, Jesus. We are going to pray. The book of Galatians 5:22 tells us that anyone that born of spirit will do things in the spirit. You are going to pray and say, Father, let your grace be sufficient for me.
Amen.
To bear fruit in spirit. To talk in spirit. Not carnal. Tell it unto God to give you the grace to be sufficient for you to speak as a spiritual man, as a spiritual woman, as a spiritual children, as a spiritual man and woman. Thank God to give you the grace. You need the grace of God to speak as a spiritual man, as a spiritual woman, because we are born in the spirit. Pray that God should give you the grace, the sufficient grace to bear good fruit. Because without Him, we can't do nothing. Father, help us. In Jesus' name, we are praying. Let's jam our two hands together for Jesus. Our Lord is good. I pray for you today, everyone, that you will receive the grace to bear good fruit for God in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So that we will not be a cast out.
Amen.
In His presence.
Amen.
So that death will not snatch us away.
Amen.
He said, those that beareth fruit, He protected them.
Amen.
To bear more and more fruit for Him.
Amen.
Father, Lord, oh God, may we never be dried.
Amen.
Father, Lord, may your grace be sufficient for us to bear good fruit for you.
Amen.
In the authority name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please, if you know that truly, you are baptized with water. Please, let not a stubborn seal of coming to die with the Lord. Know it that what you are doing